Hello and welcome back to my channel. In this week's video, I'm going to show you the framework I use. It's a very simple framework, but it's sort of like a series of steps that I use to match any writing style I want in ChatGPT. This allows me to train based on the type of content I want to generate. So it allows me to train ChatGPT into writing a more similar type of content that my audience and the people that is going to be reading that content is going to relate more. And to do so, I can use articles and already content already created, kind of like extracting those style traits that I want, and then start like building an AI personality that then I can like reuse in any future content I want to generate. So I'm in ChatGPT now and ready to start building these personalities. To build these personalities, we will need traits, so kind of like writing style traits, and they can be divided into types, what I call writing style traits and persona traits. So one of them, the writing style traits, it's what defines how the actual content it's organized, it's written, and the persona traits, it's kind of like telling us about the author himself. So what biases does the author have, demographics, what type of like goals, motivations, challenges, and so on. So I will start with the writing style traits and then like move on to the persona traits and then see how we can start building this personality. Now, to extract these writing traits, I use this prompt: analyze the text above for the following writing style traits. This is a list of a lot of different traits I have identified as being useful. Depending on what type of content you're generating, you won't need all of them. But as a first approach, it's always nice to have all of them and then like just pick the ones you need. So to start building our first personality, I will use this article. I found that it has quite a unique style of writing. It starts with Canada, Europe, Argentina, Siberia, Turkey, a planet on fire. What have we learned so far from what is perhaps humanity first proper extinction summer, blah, 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 blah. And goes on, but like quite an interesting style. It uses quotes, it uses many different things, which I found quite interesting. So we will be using this article to start extracting traits that we will be using to build our personality. So I'm gonna copy this and head to ChatGPT, gonna paste this above the prompt. Actually, I need also this. This is also very important. The author's name is Bob. Use his name to refer to him. Because if you don't do this, the traits are going to be generic. And once we have the personality, we kind of have to give a name to this personality, because then ChatGPT starts writing in a, he doesn't know if he has to describe the way of like writing or he has to, like, it's better to identify, to make ChatGPT identify with a name and then like give those traits to that name. So I'm gonna run this. Okay, this didn't work. It's gonna regenerate this. I just realized something, which is if you use GPT-4 right now, it's not going to do what you're asking to do, at least not, it's not doing it with me. It's kind of like following the text above. It's not really like actually reading what I'm saying, so it's very weird. I don't know if it's because of one of the last updates, but if you use GPT-3, it does, oops. Let's try again. Yeah, with GPT-3 it works, GPT-4 doesn't work, so. Interesting. Anyways, now we can see vocabulary. used by Bob. The vocabulary used by Bob is emotive and loaded with words like tune shaders, blah, blah, blah. This is actually what I asked him not to do. But depending on your case, you might want to add some of these like words. So maybe it defines a bit more the, like in a specific way, the styling of the author or not. Like then this is, so this is what I call a trait. And you can start combining and analyzing different articles out there and start like picking up the traits you need or you want. And then, so let's just copy this, all these traits for now. So this is also quite interesting. Well, I'm gonna go through a bit of them. Tone is impassionate, urgent and critical, but deeply concerned about the state of politics, blah, blah, blah. Sentences are often long and complex, reflecting his passionate and detailed arguments. Frequently uses ellipses to indicate the pauses and create a sense of lingering thoughts. Writes from a first person perspective, blah, blah, blah. Uses a figurative language, imaginary, and so on. No? So we can just like copy this. And this is what accounts for writing style. This is analyzing the actual text. What we will do now is do the same thing, but for the author itself. So I'm gonna ask ChatGPT now to actually describe the persona that, so the author. So I'm gonna say analyze text above, blah, blah, blah. And so now it's more about the author itself. So demographics, goals, motivation, challenges, pain points, and so on. And same, the same thing, the author's name is Bob, use his name to refer to him. You will understand why I do this once we start generating the article. So when giving examples, make them generic. Cool, and then I'm gonna add the article. Here. So, demographics. Bob appears to be well-educated and articulate. Goals and motivations. Main goal seems to be raising awareness and so on. So, I'm just gonna copy this and add it to our prompt. So now that we have our prompt ready, with that describes all the traits that our personality has to have, there is one last step that we have to do, is saying you are Bob. And what this does is to link all those traits into Bob, and then we say that for this ChatGPT session, he is going to be Bob, and so that he's going to be more less likely to add anything that has been trained on before using this prompt. So it's kind of like reinforcing this personality. What we have here is kind of like this personality that we can evolve over time. We can repeat these steps with other articles and like merge and keep the traits we want to keep, or for a particular article we want to generate, remove certain traits, add more, and so on. So it's something that we can evolve over time and have multiple personalities if we want to. Or kind of like imitating that we have like a team of authors that are kind of like different personas with their own biases, their own way of looking at life and everything. So, well, I'm gonna write the article for this. So I'm gonna ask, write an article about flying first class. Flying first class is quite generic. So I'm going to expect that it's going to add all his own biases and everything that has come, like that the personality has, into this topic. So I'm gonna as the world gasps for breath in the stifling grip of climate change, we, the comfortable and privileged few, continue to fan the flames of our demise. Flying first class, privilege indulged by select few, a bubble of opulence high above the clouds. But what about the rest of us? And more importantly, what about the planet? What is the real cost of first class? According to a report, first class passengers account for nearly four times the carbon footprint of an economy class passenger, blah, blah. This is something that we wouldn't have gotten if we just ask in a generic manner, write about flying first class. Like, let me open a new prompt, actually do the test. The art and allure of flying first class, a journey like no other. When it comes to air travel, the luxury in the sky. So it's more a more positive vibe. Like that's kind of like the generic way of GPT talking about flying first class. And so, yeah. And this is when you have a personality. So yeah, now you have a blueprint, the blueprint for this personality, which you can evolve over time and select the traits you want, remove the ones you don't want, and so on. I hope you enjoyed this week's video. If you want to support my work, please like and subscribe. It helps with the algorithm. And I post a video every Tuesday. So see you next week.